Hello, I'm John, and welcome to another tutorial in our Getting Started with Earth Studio series. In this tutorial, we'll be covering two powerful features in Earth Studio, Camera Target and Multiview. So as always, to get started, I'll make a new blank project. I'll call it Camera Target. And I'm going to navigate to Philadelphia, because they have really beautiful 3D imagery, especially downtown. And I'm going to just position my camera so that it's more or less facing Logan Circle right here. And I'll make my first camera target. And this is really simple to do. I can just right-click anywhere on the screen and select Set Camera Target from the menu. And so a lot changes here. We have our camera view here on the right that we're used to, but we also have this new view, and that's our top-down view. And this is super handy because it gives us a bird's eye perspective of our entire animation. We see our camera target represented as this little target icon right here. And we see our camera represented, both its position and orientation, as this pyramid shape right here. And this is just a standard Google map. So if we scroll in and out, we can zoom and we can click and drag to reposition the map. And the nice thing about this is that everything is dynamically linked between the top view and the camera view. So if I were to come here and drag my camera, you'll see that it locks right on to this new camera target, and everything updates in real time. So it's a really fluid way of repositioning your shot. So I can also move my camera target around right here in the top-down view. And you'll see that when I do that, there's this red circle here where my camera target used to be. And this is because there's a keyframe set there when I first set the camera target. And that shows up in our attribute list under this new group called Camera Target. And it has a longitude, latitude, and altitude with keyframe set, just like our camera position. There's also this influence attribute that we'll cover later. And because our camera target is an attribute that appears in the timeline, it means that it can also be added or removed through the Edit Attributes menu above the attribute list in the timeline. If we click here, we'll see that we have this camera target at the top, and right now it's active, it's green. We could also turn it off and turn it back on, very simply. And when we turn it on from the attribute menu, it'll just put our camera target at whatever is directly in the center of our screen. So for now, we have this camera target, its position is set, and if we move our target off the keyframe and move our playhead, it snaps the value back to the saved value. And the same thing applies with position. This is basically just like it works in normal animation. If a keyframe is set and we make changes but don't keyframe them, they won't be saved. So with that in mind, we're going to go to the last frame. We're going to move our camera target so that we're looking right over here at the Philadelphia Museum of Art, I believe is the name. And I'm going to set a camera target keyframe at the bottom here. And I'm going to do the same thing with our camera position, facing right around here, keyframe. And now you'll see that we have these lines drawn between our keyframes. And this is basically the exact path that our target and camera will follow as they move between the two keyframes that we've set. We can edit this path by dragging these keyframes, and that will actually update the value live. So now these keyframes have new values as we move them around. I'll undo that. We can also move our camera here and set a new keyframe, and our path will update. So right now we have this kind of nice view as we're traveling past Logan Circle along this road right to the Philadelphia Art Museum. But let's say around halfway here, we want to not really be so close to the road. We want to have more of a bird's eye view of the city, more of a macro view. And to do that, we're just going to drag our camera out here and we're going to create a new keyframe. And when we do that, Earth Studio automatically smooths our path so that as we go through this keyframe, instead of being a harsh angle, it's a nice smooth curve. And we'll see that we have these Bezier handles here, these easing handles that allow us to adjust the shape of this path. So if I click and drag these, we'll see that our path updates. And if we right-click on this, we'll see we have some options. We have Smooth Path, and this is our default auto-smooth algorithm, and it basically just finds the perfect tangent for longitude and latitude to give us a nice smooth curve. We also have an option to make Linear, which will get rid of any easing handles in the top view. And if we Command-click, we can toggle between Smooth and Linear. And we can also unlink these handles if we want to have direct control over one half of the keyframe. So very cool here. A few more things to cover, one of which is the other multi-view angles up here. In addition to the top view, we have a north, south, east, and west view. And these are just side views in each of the cardinal directions. So this is facing north. We can see and edit our animation from a side view, which can be really useful. We also have this influence attribute in camera target that we mentioned earlier. And this is an extremely powerful tool. You might have noticed while we've been animating that this yellow caution sign has shown up next to our camera rotation. And that's because by the nature of camera target, we're overriding our pan and tilt attribute values because we have to set those appropriately so that our camera is always facing the target. But if we were to set our influence to zero, we'll see that that caution sign is gone. And that's because whatever our values are here are now taking priority. Now our camera is totally ignoring the camera target and just going on its merry way, depending on whatever the pan and tilt keyframes are set to. And we can do some pretty cool features with this. So for example, we moved our pan here so that we're facing kind of along our path. And if we come out here to frame 240 or so, and we set our influence back to 100, we'll see that now our camera is facing the target again. And as we scrub back in time, we'll see that Earth Studio is merging those values together. It's blending them so that as we go along the animation, we're slowly pointing directly at our target. And if we ease this a lot, we can get a really smooth effect where our camera is kind of flying along its way, and then it slowly moves back to face our camera target. So that's all for now in this camera target and multi-view tutorial. As always, please check up on the documentation to see some more detailed information and some other tips and tricks about working with these tools. Until next time, thanks a lot for watching. Bye.